So first of all, quickly, let us just understand this poem. Okay, all of you look at your books, please. Online students, I'm sharing the screen for you all. Now look at this poem. Read it. Any word not clear? Let me know. Let us do the paraphrasing first, and then we'll come to the value points, or we'll do our facts and opinions. Okay? Right? What's the strength today? 22. You are a big class, 48 students, 11 have joined over here. Even then, 16 are absent. So, right. Yes, here. He stalks in his vivid stripes. Stalk, what does stalk mean? Follow, right? As nowadays on your social media, you say that way you're stalking, you're following someone, right? Their profile and all, or whatever they're doing. Otherwise, here, what is it? What do you think he's stalking then? What is he stalking in his cage? What do you think would be the appropriate meaning of stalking in this context? Moving, walking, right? Yes. He stalks in his vivid stripes. What is vivid? Bright, right? What stripes? Dhruv, where are you? Yeah, stripes, the color of the tiger stripes. See, in a second, anything can happen, you know? And of course, I told you, Dhruv was perfect till these questions, and I don't know what happened in the end. Two options, and it made a lot of difference, isn't it? Right? Yes. Right, so vivid stripes. What is the color? What is the color of the tiger? Yes, yellow, golden, right? And bright topaz color, isn't it? Right, and he has those very vivid, bright colored stripes, and they are his identity, right? That is what makes him different from the other, you can say, these wildcats. The few steps of his cage now stalks the few. Right? So he's walking, and where is he walking? In that limited space, okay? On pads of velvet quiet. What are the pads here refer to? The feet, right? So his padded feet, his cushioned feet, right? Yes, soft feet. It's not making noise. Is there a similarity between his movement and his feeling? How is he feeling? What is that anger? Suppressed. What about his movement? Can you hear the sound? Is he going bang, bang and plonk, plonk? Is he going like that? So very softly, isn't it? So there's a similarity there. He's walking softly. His anger is also suppressed. His anger is also very quiet, right? In his quiet rage. Quiet, velvet quiet. Quiet movement, quiet rage. He has not, you know, he's not expressing his anger. Yeah, this is clearly an oxymoron. When two opposite words are together, rage is anger. Rage is anger, right? In our context nowadays, we talk about rage as in a craze also nowadays. It's the rage nowadays, right? Yes, okay. Now just tell me, do you think, here, look at this first stanza, we have done the literal meaning, I've paraphrased it for you. Now, can you tell me this anger, this movement, did it happen all of a sudden or has it been acquired? Did it happen like when the tiger was brought into captivity, he was there in the cage in the zoo? Do you think his anger was quiet then also? No. Then what happened with the passage of time? What happened with the passage of time? He's learned to control his anger. Yes, because he knows that there is nothing that he can do about it, right? So even with us also it happens sometimes. Yes, we raise our voice, we protest, we get very angry. But when he realizes that nothing is going to change, nothing is going to happen, we keep quiet. Right? So this silence of the tiger, otherwise, yes, is silence a natural characteristic of the tiger? When do you think the tiger is generally silent? Yeah, while, you know, like when he's there lurking and he's there catching his prey. Otherwise, yes, the roar of the tigers reminding that, see, I am such a powerful beast, right? So it seems as if this silence has been acquired, the quiet rage. He's learned to control his anger. So how is he walking in that cage? What are his emotions as he's walking? Angry? A suppressed anger, right? Okay. Is this clear to all of you? Right? So, okay, right here now. Now, please remember one thing very, very important. When you get these questions, you're going to get multiple choice questions. There will always be a context. What is context? A reference, right? That where this line has come from, where this stanza has been taken from, or it could be the stanza is given to you and the questions are there related to it, right? Now think before you answer. Are the questions here, is the question that I've asked, is it related to the context or is it a general question? General questions will be very, very less, right? They are going to be context-based. You will be getting maximum context-based questions. Right. So even if I say like, right, I've not given you the lines, I've not given you the stanza. Right. Okay. So I can say that, why do you think the tiger walks quietly in his cage? I've given the reference of the tiger. So you understand. I've not written, why does he walk quietly? I don't expect you to make that immediate reference. So the context would be clearly, clearly mentioned. Okay. Right. And of course, in your CBSC, you know, papers there also. So all that, it would be mentioned clearly. Okay, now next one. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass, near the water hole, where plump deer pass. Whose opinion is this in this poem? In the second stanza, whose opinion is it? It's the poet. Right? He's thinking about the tiger. So if I say this opinion is of the poet, right? What kind of a person is the poet then? He's kind-hearted. Let me take out the tiger. Is it? Is he a nature lover? Okay, very nice. What else? What else? He's thinking about the feelings of the tiger. Yes? He knows the importance of freedom. Very good. What else? Yes, he's a good observer. What else? What else? Come on, let me just hear that few words that I'm really looking for. He understands the importance of freedom. Absolutely correct. Does he really appreciate or does he really understand where the wild animals need to be? Yes. So looking at his opinion over here, do you think he is happy with the tiger being in the zoo? No, he is not. Okay. So please here remember, he should be, who is he over here? Is the tiger. But who's, yes, personification, yes. Whose opinion is it? It's the poet's opinion, okay? Right. So it is, yes, here, what is given to us here, we are going to interpret on the basis of that. He should be lurking in shadow, hiding in shadows, sliding through long grass. Which are the words of movement here in this stanza? Sliding as well as lurking, right? So both of them, are they loud movements or are they soft movements? Soft, silent movement. Why does the tiger need to be silent? To catch its prey. Very nice. Very good. Okay. Through long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. Where is this water hole? It is in the wild. It's in the jungle, right? It's in the wilderness, as you might say, where the tiger lives. And we know here, this stanza, how is it different from the first one? Where is the setting of the first stanza? Setting is in the zoo. Second is in the open, in the wilderness, in the jungles, right? Where the tiger should be, right? Near the water hole. What did you think is the significance of the water hole in the life of the tiger? All the animals, they come there at some time or the other. And how is this such a good opportunity for the tiger? To catch the prey. Very nice. Where plump deer pass. The next line makes it very, very clear. Plump deer pass. Healthy deer. And of course, naturally, the tiger is tempted with by the healthy deer coming over there. What does he do? Pounces on them. Right? Now, look here. Yes. So, we have lurking, sliding. These are words of movement. Okay? Plump deer pass. Is there any literary device over here? It is. Is it the repetition of a vowel? Is there a repetition of a consonant? Where is the consonant? Which one? Plump pass. What about deer then? What will you do about that? Can I say it's alliteration? Then what will I say it is? What is the repetition of a vowel sound called? Look at plump. Deer. Pass. It's repeated. Yes. Consonant sound is initial sound. After the consonant will come the vowel sound. Plump. A sound. Deer. E sound. Pass. Ah, right, so they're vowels. What do we call a repetition of vowel sound? Come on, hurry up. Very good, very good. It is assonance. Vowel sound is assonance. Consonant sound is? Note it down somewhere if you have to. Okay, right, clear? Fine. Consonance is entirely different. We are not discussing that. We are not. Isn't it? Okay. Assonance hota hai. Assonance hota hai. Vowel sound ka repetition. Consonance likha hua. Is it? Okay. Then it is my mistake. It is assonance is there, the repetition. I'll check it, verifying it again. But this is the repetition of the vowel. Stalks and stripes. Okay, let me check. Right, this is assonance. Repetition of vowel sound is assonance. Okay, right. Repetition of a consonant sound is alliteration. Let's do the next stanza. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Baring his white fangs, his claws terrorizing the village. Right, okay. What is there, you know, like at the jungle's edge here? This is once again, where is the tiger, in the wild or in the zoo? In the wild, okay. What is he doing out in the wild? He's snarling, he's scaring. Who is he scaring? In the previous stanza, he was there, you know, like hiding and waiting to pounce on the animals. Now it is here, it is there scaring the people, right? He's scaring the people, okay. So he is at the jungle's edge, right? So he's snarling there around the houses. Now, where are the houses? In the village, right? And he is there at the edge. What is he trying to highlight? If you have to think about the tiger's behavior, what is he highlighting? That is territory, right? His dominance, okay? Yes, so about his presence there, about his position, right? Baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing. And what is he doing by showing that? Fangs. Where are the fangs? Teeth, right? So you have these big canine teeth of the tiger, which are very scary, right? And his claws. Where are the claws? On his paws. And in the first time, so what had happened to his paws? They were soft. They were padded, they were velvet, and now they are so scary. They have claws, terrifying claws. Yeah. Pehli claws ko kaise describe kiya? Uske, you know, feet ko, or you can see the pads there. How is he walking very softly? This is his change of behavior, isn't it? Right, how he is there in the zoo and how he is there and how he has suppressed his feelings. Okay, what are the sound words here in the stanza? Sound words in the stanza?
Snarling,
right? Okay, around houses, at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. So there's a sound word here. What do we call a word that replicates? Onomatopoeia. Okay, yes, this one is clear. So let us make sure here. Is like, of course, here, right? So baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Why is he terrorizing the village? So what is his attitude towards humans? What is his attitude towards humans? First, he's ignoring them in the first stanza. Let's not talk about that stanza. Let's talk about the stanza here. What is his attitude towards the humans here? Yeah, so he is showing his dominance, and what is his behavior towards human beings? That yes, I am much stronger and you stay away from my, yes, my territory. Is warning. That's why the roaring sound is showing his strength, his bearing, right? So bearing his fangs and claws, it's a sign, or it is there showing his strength, his power, his dominance, okay, right? And this is in his true colors, as we might say, right? It's there showing his true, but he's locked in a concrete cell. We know the reality. What has happened to the tiger? Where is he now? In the concrete cell. Once again, second and third stanza, whose opinion is it? Poet's opinion. What is the reality? The tiger is in the cell. The tiger is in the zoo. He's locked in a concrete cell. Yes, it's alliteration also. If you want to hear, if alliteration option is not there, there is a, yes, there's a repetition of the right. Yes, so we have concrete cell. Okay, locked in a concrete cell. His strength behind bars. Whose strength? Why is it important for man to, you know, put his strength behind the bars? Why do you think man has done that? So other people can come and see. One is that. Second, what could be? Look at the previous paragraph. What was the tiger doing? Snarling, terrorizing. Now where is he? What has happened to his strength? What has happened to the strength? Yes, so he is there, you know, like very complacent and very suppressed. Yes, so man is showing his dominance. Who is showing his dominance in the previous paragraph? Tiger. Now he's showing man. And I have put you in the cage. Now you can see who is stronger. Yes. Okay. So it's a battle of strength both ways. Stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Why does he ignore the visitors? There's so many. I'm so popular. I don't need them. Is it? Then? Yes. Why is he ignoring visitors? Because he's used to humans coming and looking at him, right? Yes. Is he showing his resentment? Is he showing his quiet anger? Yes. Raghav, why do you think he's ignoring visitors? He's used to human beings now, and he sees them coming every day and looking at him, and yeah, so he's not bothered only. Right, and he's learned there. Initially, he might have got angry, he might have roared at them, but with the passage of time, what has happened? Yes, yeah, so he started keeping quiet. So he thought it's better to keep quiet. Okay. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. Big, you can say contrast here. What do the patrolling cars do? They're watching over the animals, or they're watching over the safety, the security. Everyone is safe. All the animals locked, right? And of course, it's a big contrast to the behavior of the tiger in the wilderness. What does the tiger do in the wilderness? Murder? Why murder? It's not a murder. It's his nature. It's his nature, right? So it's a wild cat we're talking about. We're talking a beast here, right? He goes there hunting for his prey. Right, so we have, yes, a very royal, majestic animal. And so he has, it's his natural instinct, right? So he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. What is the last voice? The patrolling cars. What a kind of a sound do you think the patrolling cars make? Yeah, so the hooters and the sirens, maybe, yeah, just telling that, yeah, I don't want this sound here, right? Stay, okay, please keep your hooters off now. And stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Why does he look out at the stars? So, yes, what do the stars remind him of? His home, of the open, of the wild. And yes, so that has that desire to be free vanished. Look at the first stanza. Quiet rage. It seems as if he suppressed himself. Last night he's staring at the stars. So is there that desire for freedom still there in him? Yes, so he longs to be out in the open where he can. Where can he look at the stars there in the open? Right, of course, the vast expanse of sky. Here, he's just able to see what he could, you know, from the concrete cell behind the bars, right? Or in that cage or wherever he is in the captivity. At the brilliant stars. Brilliant eyes, brilliant stars. Why this brilliant has been repeated? What is there? Brilliant eyes. Shining with what? Tears. How nice. Shining with tears. Shining with anger. That anger is still there at night when he looks at the stars. What is there then? Brilliant eyes. What is there so bright in his eyes? What could be there? That hope, that hunger, that desire for freedom. And the brilliant stars. They shine brightly at night. That is there, you know, like, of course, yes. How the stars, right, they get their light and all. We all know that, okay? Fine. Yes, so just go through this. This is all what? Facts, which are given to us. On the basis of this, what can we say about the tiger's behavior? Huh? Second, right, it is a poet's opinion. It's a poet's opinion. But here, hamare samne kya hai? They are facts, okay, right? So it is the poets there, the second and third. And we know here, what does this paragraph, what are the contrast which is brought about in this paragraph? Yeah, the tiger in the zoo and the tiger in the wild, okay, right? Does it talk about human behavior also? What about human behavior? Does it tell us? Yes. Right. So here, like, see here, look at the third stanza. Man is afraid of the tiger. In the first stanza here, where the tiger is there walking in his cage, do you think man is afraid there? In the last stanza, is man afraid of the tiger? Last stanza. He's patrolling and look at him, he's showing his strength and might. Right? So when does man show his courage or his might in front of the tiger according to what the poet has said? When the tiger is in captivity. So when the tiger is in the wilderness, no, he's gonna run away. Isn't it right? So if he's going to, yes, be afraid for his, yes. Attendance, online students. Nahi, second mein kyun first line ke baad kya hai? Yeah. Cue bearing his look at here. He should be snarling at the jungle's edge, bearing his white fingers, his claws terrorizing the village. There's an exclamation mark. Enjambment is generally in the next stanza. The next stanza starts off. The first stanza continues into the second without any punctuation. Right? There is a full stop over here. There is one over here also. So let me just see, right, how many participants are there. Note down. Let us do the textual questions also. Ayush is there, Diya is there, Harshit is there. See, make sure that you know the meaning of each and every word of the poem. There could be a vocabulary question. There could be a situation-based question here directly from the context, okay? There could be facts and opinions, right? And of course, here you can't get sequence questions here. You can analyze yourself first. You can get an idea that, can I get a sequence-based question here? What happens first and what comes later? In poetry, no. Right, but yes, there are certain poems where you can have, like, you talk about dust of snow, huh? So there are a number of incidents that happen over there. Poet name, please learn them. How many poems do we have? Yes, come on, tell me how many poems do we have. We have dust of snow, fire and ice, tiger in the zoo, and ball poem. Ball poem is very, very important. Right? Yes. So this also has a deep meaning. All these poems have a very, you can say, symbolic also and a metaphorical representation.